Thank you. Testing. Oh, yes, it works. Hi, everyone. So glad that you are here. This is our final masterworks of this very interesting season, the season of COVID, and we're glad you're here. We're glad that we are seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. So much good news recently in terms of the world pandemic, and just before I forget, I'll apologize for losing my mask in about the last 60 or 70 bars of the concerto. I went to turn a page, and I'm used to licking my finger to turn the page. I missed and turned like three pages. At that moment, I decided the music was more important than the mask on my face, so I got rid of it. But it'll come back. It'll stay here for a few more days. So we're going to spend a little bit of time in between the Elgar Concerto and the next work, just talking to you about the concert and about the works on the concert. It's a very interesting concert in that we have two, you know, we call them war horses, the Elgar Cello Concerto, the Gershwin American in Paris, two of the most popular pieces ever for live orchestra, and then two new works. I'm gonna talk in sort of in out of order about these works. I first wanna talk about the Elgar, and not so much the Elgar, but the person who just played it. The Sphinx organization, which is based out of Detroit, is one of the very most important organizations involved with classical music today. Their sole purpose is to support and really shepherd as best they can the careers of amazingly talented young persons of color, African-American, Latinx players. And they have already really made their mark in the American orchestra world and the solo world and the chamber music world. There's a major concerto competition every year at Sphinx. And in 2020, just a couple of months before COVID hit, the competition was held in Detroit. I was there, some other members of the Memphis Symphony were there, and we heard the winner play. His name was Gabriel Martins. He's the fellow you just heard play the Elgar Concerto. I think this is a serious voice in the future of cello performance. This is a major, major player. Said differently, this guy can play. If you will, please welcome back to the stage, Gabriel Martins. So I've had him bring his cello for a reason that we'll get to in just a moment, but before we do, would you maybe tell folks who you are, where are you from, and where did you grow up, and when did you start playing the cello, and also tell us a bit about this instrument. It's pretty phenomenal.
Yeah, thank you very much. I hope you can hear me. My name is Gabriel Martins, as you see in your program. I grew up in the small town of Bloomington, Indiana, which is home to Indiana University, which happens to have an incredibly wonderful and rich, vibrant music school, the Jacobs School of Music. So I was very fortunate to kind of come across that when I was young. This instrument here, I recently came into possession of. It's actually a composite instrument, which means that the back and the sides were made from one particular maker by the name of Francesco Ruggeri in 1690 in Cremona, Italy. And then the front of the instrument was later replaced due to some terrible damages from the original model. And this was made by an English maker in the early 1800s by the name of Robert Kraske.
It's a really amazing instrument. And You just played the Elgar. You actually won the concerto competition playing the last movement of the Elgar. So if you want to see him play that on YouTube, it exists. The final movement, it's really easy to find. Talk just quickly about the Sphinx organization and what's your connection to it, and how have you been involved in it as you've moved through your, you know, this not really beginning anymore, but into your career.
Sure. Yeah, the Sphinx organization has been around for a little over 20 years now. I've been involved with them since 2017, when I first went to their big competition. And that time I won the third prize, and then the year after that I came back, won the second prize, and then after that I came back and won the first prize. So they've been very good to me over the years. I'm very, very grateful for everything they do. It's an absolutely wonderful organization. You can read about them and their mission and everything they're doing. It's growing. It's such a wonderful community of people. It's really great, so feel free to check that out if you're interested.
And finally, on purpose, I said to Gabriel, let's not have you rush back out after the Elgar and play an encore, but I thought now might be a good time if you're interested in attending. Good, it'll be good.
I'll play a very short piece that many of you probably know or at least recognize. This is the prelude of Johann Sebastian Bach's first cello suite.